Hey basketball coaches and players, today I am going to give you a 2-3 trap zone defense. But first, if you want a really killer basketball defense, make sure to go check out the Unbeatable and Perimeter Basketball Defense books down in the description below. Okay, so if you're new to a zone defense, this would be a 2-3 zone. We have two players up top and then three players down in the bottom. In a regular zone, these players will be guarding an individual area and not an individual man unless that man is with the ball in their area. Now, what we are going to have in this case, let's say player one has that ball. Player one is going to be guarding player one. We are now going to be having player two move up. Player 4 move in, and now because player 5 is in the low post, we would have player 5 red down there guarding him in this trap zone, and we would have player 3 move up. This makes it look like a man-to-man, and that's what we really want to try and do in any zone, because to make a perfect zone, you're going to make it look like a man-to-man defense. Now, let's say, for example, we have player 1 pass over to player 3. Our whole main goal is to trap the player, whoever has that ball, in these two corners. That is the idea behind a trap defense in the half court. Or try to trap any player along the baseline. There's basically two different strategies that we have here. Now, what we are going to do is to try and force all of our players to go towards the sideline, which means that we are going to try and have our players ride the hips on this side of the player to try and force him again towards the baseline. Now, if player 3 starts dribbling down towards the baseline, what we are going to do now is to have player 4. He's going to start moving down and guarding the middle of the key. We're going to have player 2 slide down to guard that high post and essentially to guard these two players for any kick out skip passes. We're going to have player 1 move down to try and cut off that pass back up top. And player 5 is going to start moving or trying to move in front of player 5 blue. And there's a reason behind this. The reason is as soon as player 3 gets down towards the baseline, we're going to have player 5 jump out, and now we have trapped player 3. At this point in time, we're going to have player 4 move and defend player 5, and we're going to have player 2 move down. Player 1 is going to be sagging closer towards the middle of the key. We have now created a trap. If he tries to pass out, we're going to have player 1 covering that man. We're going to be having player 2 still guarding that low area because of any weak side baseline cuts, but he needs to be open and quick enough to be able to cut off any skip lob passes out to any players on this side. We have now essentially trapped player 3. Again, you're only allowed to be trapped depending on the league. Usually the leagues will give you between 3 and 5 seconds. If you don't advance the ball, then they start calling it a turnover, or he may just turn over the ball himself or step out of bounds. Now, if, for example, we get that ball over to player one, and now we have player one passing into player five, well, what can we do now? Well, what I want to do is have player three go down and trap player five. Player 1 is going to now slightly move down, and they are going to be trying to force player 5 towards the baseline so that they can trap him along the baseline. Again, at this point in time, we are going to be having player 4. If there's nobody in this post, player 4 can stay over here, but I would really personally rather have him down guarding the middle of the key for anyone who is trying to cut down the middle of the key. And again, player 2 is going to slightly move down again to cut off any players who are trying to cut baseline. Again, still open to be able to cut off any passes that are popping out from player 5. This is by no means an easy defense to teach to your team. However, if you have mastered this zone, you are going to be super successful running the 2-3 zone because you're going to be trapping a lot of players along that baseline. But also, it allows you to run specialized zones like my unbeatable zone defense I mentioned earlier that you can purchase down in the description below. I hope that you've enjoyed today's video. I hope that this video has helped your team become better and defend better. If it has, hit that like button and subscribe, and I'll see you guys again next time.